preacher, Brother Taylor, dropped by today. Said he'd be pleased to have dinner.
Well, I've been here since the early 60s. Well, my folks moved here in 44, and my brothers and I got our haircuts in here. And I started working in here in the 60s, and off and on. Then the Beatles come out, and all the barbershops went under. And so I went back to where I used to work at DuPont's in Newburgh. And then Dominic, the owner, he went to Florida, and I stayed here. That was in 83. So I've been here a while. I put the signs all up.
Did you make those?
Yeah. I covered up the wall so I don't have to paint. I had a friend of mine, Roger. We played in the band together. He's the one that made these signs. You see the horses up there on the wall, Mike? And he made that sign. He got so much of his stuff in here, I thought it was an art gallery after a while. Now he's passed on, but he was a drummer too, besides being an artist. I got a lot of his stuff in here. This wall here is all cars, because I started putting pictures of cars up. The top row up there is all trucks, and the guy never come back for them, so I stuck them up there, and people took an interest in it. So within a couple months, I had the whole wall filled up with cars. They get the most interest besides the UFOs. The cars are the number two. And then let's see what else is in here. Nothing much else in all my book. We have strange things that's happening in our house. We live down by the park, and a lot of stuff happening. My daughter saw the shadow under the shadow people. I don't know if you're familiar with that, but it really scared her. She was in her room, and it come right through the wall. Stood right in front of the TV. And my son saw one. I mean, this was a rectangular one. They're the huge ones. I mean, some of these things are the size of a 2 or 3 football fields. Come right up from the field, treetop level, him and his buddy, Joe, and he wouldn't even talk about it. Hovered right over our house, treetop level. It covered up, it was a size so big it covered up 3 houses down there. And it swung around and then it took off up towards town. By the time I got out there, it was gone. So Joe became another non-believer, an instant believer. Oh, let me get you the picture I got back here. And this was seen about 10 years ago, 20 years ago, 1995. It was seen in a field by 5 people, and 3 of them had cameras. Nobody took a picture. My friend Jimmy from Connecticut, he drew this. He was a commercial artist, so he drew it. And I have this on the back, if you can see it. It's getting kind of beat up now. And it was heard all summer. There's a big hill there. And it was heard up on this hill, and then it ended up in this field. 8 to 10 feet tall. It went 50 yards in a blink of an eye. Mixed screams like a female, shrill pitch. Oh, 12 to 14 feet tall. 150 yards in the blink of an eye, because Jimmy hit it with a big, powerful flashlight he had. He was in pretty good shape for being 20 years old. Oh, here's a good one. Reincarnation. UFOs. I could go right down the whole list. That's metaphysics. You ever read any books on reincarnation?
I'm familiar with the concept, but I've never read any in-depth books.
Yeah, you don't know what you're missing.
What's the life reading?
It goes into your past lives.
And who would do a life reading? Like,
you have to go to a psychic center. You can't go to a churches. They don't kind of like to talk about that. But you go to a good psychic. We used to go to a guy, Bob Johnson. You know, one of his clients was, her brother is a big famous movie star. I could tell you about that. We went for a group reading. One of the guys had bad ears. He had a brother and a sister, and all of them had bad ears. And when Bob Johnson would go into a trance, and they called themselves the group, they would come through him. His voice would change, his facial would, his whole body wouldn't change, but his voice would change. And it,